Hello everyone, how are you all? I hope you all are fine. Welcome to our English class. Today we are going to study module 5 session 2. Okay, and in this module we are going to study the following points: degrees of comparison, summary writing and dialogue writing. Okay, so what are we going to study? Degrees of comparison, summary writing and dialogue writing. Okay, so do you remember what have we studied in the previous session? Yes, in the previous session we have studied about the adjectives. This means the describing words. Okay, so today we will study degrees of comparison of that particular adjectives. Okay, now let us see our first slide. Degrees of comparison. Now what do you mean by degrees of comparison? First of all, I would like to tell you that there are 3 degrees of comparison. How many? 3. First is positive, second is comparative and next is superlative. Okay, these are the 3 degrees of comparison. So can you see this picture? Yes, this picture is of Delhi. Okay, and what is mentioned in the sentence? That Delhi is cold during winter. What is mentioned? Delhi is cold during winter. Okay, next is about Shimla. Okay, as you can see there's a lot of ice here. Okay, like lot of snow which is fallen on the grounds, on the rooftops, on the trees, right? So what do you think? This place is cold, more cold, or this? Yes, which place is having more cold? Yes, this place. So what is the word that we use? Colder. So this place is colder than Delhi. Okay, so Shimla is colder than Delhi. Now can you see the third picture? Yes, it is about Leh. Okay, do you know Leh Ladakh? You might have heard, right? So these places are very cold places. Okay, and there is a lot of snowfall in these places. Okay, so Leh is the coldest of the 3 cities. Okay, so first of all I will explain you. Okay, Delhi is cold. Now in the first sentence what is mentioned? That Delhi is cold. Okay, now here the adjective cold is describing the weather of Delhi. Now here Delhi is not compared to any other city. Okay, in the first sentence. But in the second sentence Delhi is compared to Shimla. Okay, so as compared to Delhi, Shimla is colder. Okay, so Shimla is colder than Delhi during winter. So Shimla is colder than Delhi. Now whenever we are comparing the 2 things, that time we use the comparative degree, that is colder. Cold, colder. Cold is the positive degree that we have used in the first sentence, just to explain or just to describe about something. And in the second sentence we have used the comparative degree to compare the 2 cities. Okay, so Shimla is colder than Delhi during winter. Next is Leh. Okay, so Leh is the coldest of 3 cities. Now this city is coldest among all the 3 cities. Leh is colder than Shimla as well as it is colder than Delhi. So we have mentioned coldest of all the 3 cities. Okay, so in the first sentence cold is an adjective that simply describes the weather conditions during Delhi. Okay, during winter in Delhi. Next sentence, the adjective colder compares between Shimla and Delhi. And in the third sentence, coldest is used to compare the weather conditions during winter in all the 3 cities. Okay, it also shows that which city is most cold. Okay, so here have you understood about the comparison of degrees? All right. So these are the 3 forms which we are using for the comparison. First is positive degree. Now as it is mentioned, there are 3 degrees of comparison with positive degree, comparative degree and superlative degree. Okay, positive, comparative and superlative. Positive degree is used to describe something. Comparative degree is used to compare two things. Okay, two things, two people, two places, two animals. Okay, like you can say cheetah is the fast, sorry, cheetah is fast, running faster than tiger. Okay, but at the same time you can also say that cheetah is the fastest running of all animals, fastest running animal among all the animals. All right, so your example is of cold, colder than coldest. So see the first sentence, the positive degree is used to describe something. Okay, for example, clever, strong, small. Like we can say that he is clever, or we can take a name of a person and we can say that Rajat is clever. All right, this is the comparative degree. Now in comparative degree we make comparison between two things. Okay, and we use ER to compare. What do we use? ER for comparing between the two things. Now see, Ramu is quicker than Mohan. Now quick is positive degree, as it is, Ramu is quick, so it is just giving us more information about Ramu. And what is mentioned? That Ramu is quicker than Mohan. Now Mohan and Ramu are compared, so Ramu is quicker than Mohan. For writing the comparative degree we use ER as well as we use than. Okay, so always remember this thing. As in the first sentence I have told that Rajat is clever, so you can say Rajat is cleverer than Sam. Okay, next, the superlative degree. Now what can you say about the superlative degree? That it is used to compare more than two things, and also shows that it is highest among all. Okay, if many things are mentioned over there, and if you want to say that this is the best thing, okay, so we can use the superlative degree for that. Now here in the superlative degree we use EST. Okay, we use EST, we just add EST to the positive word. Okay, like for example, clever becomes cleverest, strong becomes strongest, small becomes smallest. So as we have told, so Rakesh is the quickest boy in the class. Now here Rakesh is compared to all the other boys in the class. Okay, here Ramu is quicker than Mohan. What is mentioned? Ramu is quicker than Mohan. So Ramu is compared to only one boy. Okay, but in the superlative degree Rakesh is compared to whole class, means he is compared with the boys of whole class. So Rakesh is the quickest boy in the class. Understood? So in the positive degree we just use the normal describing word, and in comparative degree we use the word plus ER. We add ER. As you can see, clever, cleverer, strong, stronger, smaller, small, smaller. Okay, and we also use then, as it is mentioned here. Now while writing the superlative degree, what we have to do? We have to add EST. Okay, and we also use the word among, as it is mentioned among all the class. Understood? Or it is mentioned about all the objects or all the things, all the places we are talking about. Understood, my dear children? So this is about the three degrees of comparison, which are positive, comparative and superlative. Okay, let us see the next slide. Now here there are some adjectives like and their positive, comparative and superlative degree is mentioned. For example, short, when we add ER to the word short, it becomes shorter. After that, when we add EST to the word short, it becomes shortest, which is the superlative degree. So short, shorter, shortest. Long, longer, longest. Smart, smarter, smartest. Old, older, oldest. Or we can use elder and eldest also for the word old. Okay? For example, that Tina is shorter than me. Okay? And we can also mention that Neha is shortest among all the girls in the class. Okay? Next, old, older, oldest. Means you can say that Ram is older than me. Alright? And you can also say that Raghu is oldest among all the boys in the class. So comparative and comparative degree is used to compare two people, and superlative degree is used to compare more than two people. Understood? We have more words here. Rich, richer, richest. See over here ER and ESTR added to the root word. Okay, my dear children? So weak becomes weak, weaker, weakest. New becomes newer in comparative degree and newest in superlative degree. Understood? Now let us see the next slide. That is exercise 3.2. Now here, complete the table with positive, comparative or superlative degrees of the given adjective. One is done for you. Now what you have to do? You just have to write the positive, comparative or superlative degree of the given word. You have to solve this exercise on your own. Okay, here is exercise 3.3. Fill in the blanks with the correct forms of adjectives in the brackets. Okay, in the bracket adjectives are given. You just have to use the correct degree of that adjective. Okay, now here in Praveen is too lazy to exercise daily. So here lazy was given and positive degree is only accepted. So you just have to check if more than two people are compared, you just have to use comparative degree. Superlative degree, and if only one person is compared, then you have to use comparative degree. Okay, let us see the next slide. Here are the examples of the exercise that you have to solve. Okay, now next slide. Now let us see what is our next exercise. Exercise 3.4. Rewrite the paragraph using the correct degrees of comparison. One is done for you. Now, the paragraph is already mentioned. What you have to do is, you have to find out the correct degree of comparison and you have to complete this paragraph. Okay? Now, let us see the next point. And our next point is summary writing. Now, summary writing is just a short piece of writing where we include only the main points. Okay? What is summary writing? Summary writing is a short piece of writing. And even if we are writing a whole book, we can write a short piece about it. Means we can write the important information about that book. Only the important points that we have mentioned in the book. Okay. So that is known as summary writing. Means just short piece of information which tells us about whatever the whole writing part is about. Okay. A summary is a short piece of writing and it contains the most important information. Now here, exercise 4 is given. Read the passage and summarize it in 5 lines by answering the questions. So what you have to do? See, Mani was assigned a big project in his science class. He wanted to do it well, but he did not want to work hard. Mani had 2 weeks to submit the project. He could have gone home and started the project. Instead, he went to play with his friends. When his father asked him to clean his room, Mani happily cleaned it. He did everything other than the project in the next few days. His friend Jishnu asked him about his progress on the project. Mani lied, saying that he had completed it. Suddenly, he realized that the project was due in 2 days. Mani became anxious. He was too afraid to tell his parents. He rushed to his room and started to work on his project. He was so worried that he could not eat well for next 2 days. On the day of submission, Mani managed to submit his finished project. He was not happy with what he had done. He promised himself that he would begin his tasks on time. Now this story is about a boy named Mani who has not taken the work seriously and he has kept on playing and doing all the other things other than the project which was assigned to him. Okay, so in this paragraph we have understood the things about money. Okay, and money was a boy who had to submit the project in 2 weeks. Now he had 2 weeks, but what had happened? He has not started the work on time priorly, right? So, and he remembered about it when there were only 2 days left. Now the thing that we can do in 2 weeks cannot be done in 2 days. Means it can be done, but it will not be the way we want, right? Most of the times we people also do the same thing, right? If any project is assigned or any work is assigned to us and 4 to 5 days are allotted for it, then what we do? Still there is time, much time with us, right? So we will not do it, we will just ignore it, right? We ignore that project or we ignore that work, we keep on doing the other things. And when there it is the time for submission, that time we realize that there are only few days or only less time with us, and that time we start doing it, and then we have to do everything in a hurry, right? So this is what it is mentioned about money. But at the end he realizes, he finishes his project, he submits the project, but at the end he realizes that we should do his work on time. Okay, my dear children, so here there are few questions which will help you to write the summary. Now we don't have to write this whole passage, we just have to write a short piece of it. So who is the main character? Money. Money is the main character. What did they do or say? Now what did money do? Money was not doing his project work and he was just keeping on doing other things. Okay, let us see the next part. Next is, what was the problem? That money was not concentrating on his work. He was doing other things instead of doing his project. Now how was it solved? He did the project within 2 days, right? So the problem was solved. Now how did it end? Problem was solved, but at the end the project how money wanted it was not like that. He was afraid to tell his parents, as his parents will scold him. So he had not taken help of anyone and he has done his project on his own. And it was not up to the mark as he wanted. Okay. So my dear children, at the end he realized about it, that you have to mention in the paragraph. Okay. So you have to write a short summary about money. Next. Now next is about dialogue writing. Now what do you mean by dialogue? Dialogue means whatever conversation we are having with each other, that direct conversation is to be mentioned in the dialogue writing. Okay, like how are you? Then you will reply, yes, I am fine. What about you? So these are the direct conversation between two people. Okay, two or more people. So that we have to mention over here. In how we have to mention the direct language that we are using in the conversation. So read a dialogue between two friends who are discussing their likes and dislikes. One of them loves dogs and the other loves to dance. So Faisal, hello Judy, how are you? Judy, I am fine, thank you. How are you Faisal? Then Faisal again replies, I am fine as well. What do you like to do in your free time, Judy? So Judy says that I love playing with my dog, Foofy. I love dogs. So Faisal, oh, I am very scared of them. Why do you like them? They scratch people and bark at them. Then what Judy says, that is true, but dogs are much more than that. They are great companions. It is not very difficult to take care of them either. What about you Faisal? What do you like to do in your free time? Now let us see the next page. Faisal, well, I enjoy dancing. Whenever I find the time, I start dancing and practicing new movies. Judy, how wonderful. I wish I could dance too. Faisal, oh, I can teach you a few dance moves. They are very easy. Judy, all right, thank you. Now here, there was conversation between the two friends, Judy and Faisal. Okay, So what happened? They were discussing about their likes and their wishes. Okay. So have you seen there was direct conversation? Okay. The second or third person was not telling their likes and wishes, right? They were telling it themselves. So over here, the first person is acting. Means it is directly told by the person. Understood, my dear children? So now let us see exercise 5. Write a dialogue between a sister and her younger brother about his first day of school. He is nervous about going to a new school. Include the advice that his sister gives him. Use the hints to help. Now over here, the hints are given. Now what you have to do, my dear children? There's a boy who is worried to go to the new school. It is his first day of school and he is worried about it. Okay. So his sister wants to explain him or wants to advise him not to worry, or you can say that you're going to school and first day you will meet your new friends, new teachers. Okay. So you should be happy. You shouldn't be nervous. Right. So the sister has to advise him. Here are the hints given to you. So you just have to look at the hints and write down the dialogue between a younger brother and sister. You can also give the names to them. Alright. So here we have completed with the dialogue writing. So which are the points that we have seen today? We have seen degrees of comparison that are positive, comparative and superlative. Then we have seen the summary writing. And summary means what? The short piece of writing which gives information. Okay. And then next is dialogue writing. And what do you mean by dialogue writing? Dialogue writing is the conversation between the two or more person. Okay. I hope you have understood this session. If you have any problem, any queries related to the session, you can contact me. Okay, my dear children. Thank you so much.